Hi guys. Hi, I'm Manu. I work for a software architect from Flipkart. Today I'm going to talk about Decision Science platform, a platform we have built for scaling models. We have had great success. I want to share our success story with you. So what are the challenges people in Flipkart who are working on the business end but are doing analysis of business data facing, right? So firstly, the users spend a lot of time in data plumbing. They download large data sets on their laptop. They run R scripts, they run Python scripts. Sometimes doing data analysis on top of large amount of data on their local laptops or even in a remote machine might not even be possible, because of the amount of data involved. So what kind of models are we talking about? Here we are talking about some simple formulae, maybe some linear regression model, to what we do in demand planning, specific use case that we are working on that uses feed forward neural network. So how do you scale something as complex as feed forward neural network to a simple formula and give very basic constructs to your business users and data analysts and scale their use case, okay? So the problem statement that our platform faced is something like this. See, our users are very different. So we have data scientists, people who typically come from programming background, and we also have business analysts, people who come from an MBA, they started writing Excel macros, and now they have graduated to this programming language R. So the language and runtimes and libraries, they're like very diverse. And the user persona is also very diverse. So target users, they have a widespread requirements. So we have like running optimizer for supply chain network, where we'll run integer linear programming to find out what are the best routes between cities to send goods. So that's something that we work on. And also working for, trying to compute price elasticity of a product. That is, you know, like given a price, how much will this product sell? So we came up with very minimalistic constructs. We didn't want to build a ML platform or anything. So the scale problem is there in all of these use cases. We have this use case of running business logic and machine learning models on large amount of data. So the solution that we have built right now, it is called DSP, Decision Science Platform. So what we have built is, it's a workflow as a service, essentially. A workflow which is language agnostic and it's runtime agnostic. So think of a workflow where, you know, it has, let's say, three steps, and step one runs in Python, step two runs in R, and step three again runs in Python, okay? So each step of the workflow has its own container, and hence its own runtime. And it is linearly horizontally scalable. And also the data scatter gather happens through the platform. So let's say step one runs for, let's say, all users. And now let's say you want to run step two for specific segments of user. The platform actually takes care of data scatter at step one and data gather at step two. The interfacing is something that we wanted to be as simple as possible. So we even as of now, we don't have a web-based UI for our platform. So we have given a command line utility. It's literally a jar, and that jar actually runs out of user's laptop. So the reason we took this approach is, we want users to be as comfortable within their IDE. So people are comfortable with PyCharm, that's a IDE for Python. People are comfortable with RStudio, that's an IDE for R. So we want them to be within their comfort zone, but also encapsulate all the higher level constructs within the platform. So the client, which is a command line tool, which is a thin client that runs out of user's laptop, it encapsulates Git. So the client pushes the data into cloud, and it executes the script on the cloud and makes the data available for user. So these are the frameworks that we use. So Mesos is at the center of all this. So Mesos does the container management. We use Docker to specify the container, which language and which packages that we would need in the container. So Hive is used for data pre-processing and post-processing. And then we have Hadoop as a runtime. So this is the architecture. We are out of time. Thanks for listening. Yeah. So this is the architecture. So we have a client that is in running out of user's laptop that talks to a web-based service. The MySQL holds all the metadata. So how many workflows are onboarded and what are the actions on those workflows? And we use Azkaban for our workflow management. Azkaban is a LinkedIn developed framework. Then we use, like I said, Apache Mesos, which does the container management. So Mesos has this thing called roles. So you can specify, I now want a container that contains two cores and these many GBs of RAM. And we would run that script on that spec of container. So the actual script is read from GitHub. So that is the enterprise software that manages Git repositories for Flipkart. And the script execution happens within the container.